Hello, my name is James Whiffen, and welcome to my masterclass on installing things in After Effects. Today we're going to be looking at four ways to install different things, including plugins, script UI panels, CP panels, and presets on Windows and Macintosh. The time codes for each one is down below.
Okay, first up we're going to show how to install a plugin on Windows.
The first step is to find your After Effects location. On Windows, that would be C, Program Files, Adobe, and here we have all the cracked versions of Adobe products that we have. I'm going to install it in 2019. Then we come into Support Files under Plugins. You may see some folders that already exist in here, that's fine. We don't need to install it in those folders, we can put it anywhere, or if we want to be organized, we can put it in a folder. Now the folders don't matter what they're called. The only thing that matters is that your plugin is in here. Doesn't matter what you call it. See, I've called it crackplugin.aex, but that's not what its name will appear inside After Effects. You can call it anything you want. One other thing I'd like to mention is if your plugin is compatible with After Effects and Premiere, then you can come to this location, C, Program Files, Adobe Common Plugins, and then your version, Media Core. And then if you drag the plugin, which I don't have anymore, into there, it will then be loaded by both hosts, Premiere and After Effects, and you're good to go. On Macintosh, things are a bit different. We come to Applications, and then we can see all our versions of After Effects there. And then we go into Plugins, and the same applies. The Macintosh Media Core is in under Library Application Support, Adobe, Common, Plugins, Version Number, and then Media Core. And then you can place your plugin here and it will be loaded by Premiere and After Effects. Now I'll be installing a ZXP extension on Windows. You have two options here. You can either use the ZXP installer or the AEScripts ZXP installer, but not both. So what we do is we drag the ZXP there, we get this animation here, tells us it's installing, and then we have to wait patiently. Okay, it says our extension has been installed. We need to restart our Adobe application. And now your ZXP will be available under Windows Extensions. But if something went wrong and you need to do a manual installation, we can do that as well. So in Explorer, we come to C, Program Files times 86. Oops. Common Files, Adobe. CP extensions, and we can see all the extensions that we have here. So we can see that File Hunter was installed under this folder here. We can go in there, and if something went wrong, maybe not all the files are there, but yeah. Okay, I'm not summoned in.
Installing a CEP panel on Mac is pretty much the exact same process. We grab the file, drag it into the ZXP installer.
Now it's told us that our extension has been installed. We can restart After Effects and File Hunter will be installed. If you would like to do a manual installation, you can come to the location here, which is Library Application Support Adobe CEP Extensions. And this is actually where the ZXP installer has placed our File Hunter. So if the installation goes wrong or you're missing some files, you can do a manual installation if that suits you. Now we'll talk about installing script UI panels on Windows. The location is C, Program Files, Adobe, Your Version, Support Files, and then Scripts. However, these scripts will only appear under File, Scripts, and you can run any script file that will prompt you to browse for your file. Or you can select the ones here which have been, After Effects just crashed, which are here. The other place you'd probably like to install them is under Scripts, Script UI Panels, and these ones are dockable that you can then move around and place wherever you like, and they'll be available under Window. I would show you in After Effects, but it's gone, so yeah. Okay, After Effects has recovered. We've got them under Window, and here are all the script UI panels. As mentioned, they come in a little dockable form that you can then move around or make full screen Oh, no, you can't make a full screen with the tilde key. Anyway, that's how to use ScriptUI panels.
And now a look at how to install a script panel on Mac.
These are inferior to plugins, but nonetheless, we will show you how to install them. So we want to come to Applications, Adobe After Effects version, and then Scripts. We can see we have some scripts here, and these ones are available in File, Scripts, and we can see them there. However, if we want a float-out panel like this EasonWiz here, we don't want to install it there. We want to install it under ScriptUI panels, and then that's where EasonWiz is. Then to see that, we come up to Window, and here are all our ScriptUI panels here. And we come to whichever one we want, and then it's going to be in a little dockable panel that we can move anywhere we like. And Matt has ruined my recording by typing, but that's okay. So that is how to install a script on Mac. Now we're going to be talking about how to use presets. Presets. So, come to Documents, Adobe, your version, user presets, and we can see we have the .ffx presets here. We have Deep Glow from years back when it was a preset, and if we come into After Effects here, those will pop up under Effects and Presets. And the cool thing about this is you don't need to restart After Effects, you can just right click and refresh that, and then we type in Deep Glow and there we have it. Make sure that you don't make any spelling mistakes. If we went Derp Glow, we're not going to see it appear there, so yeah, easy mistake to make. Now we'll be talking about installing presets on Macintosh. I'm in Users, Myself, Documents, Adobe. Then we come to the version that we want, and then there's User Presets. As you can see, these are .ffx, and if we'd want to access them, we can come into Effects and Presets, and then type in the one we want. The great thing about presets is that you don't need to restart After Effects. You can simply refresh the list. That can't be said for plugins.